So today I'm going to be testing the new Innovate Roadfly. It's a lightweight shoe and I would say it's a very versatile shoe. I think it's good for road sections. I think if you want to go on some light trails, it'd be good for that. It's a good everyday shoe. I wouldn't say it's a shoe for to cover everything. I think it's a good shoe to slot into a rotation. So I think most people nowadays understand about having shoe rotation and having more than one pair of shoes to see you through your training. I think most people these days would probably have a mileage shoe, a shoe for putting the long steady miles in, a max cushion shoe to absorb the shock and have a nice roll off the toe. Likewise, I think they'll also have a shoe for faster, quicker training, for speed work, for sessions. And then finally, they'd have a shoe to race in as well, like a carbon plated super shoe. So there's not much the shoe couldn't do, but I personally, I think it would slot into a sort of a good session shoe, a good shoe for doing the speed work in. I think it'd be great on the track, doing like track reps. I think it's a great shoe for getting that ground feel back again. I think everyone's wearing so much max cushion, super shoes, plated shoes, that you kind of, your feet are just there rolling all the time. I think it's quite nice to have a shoe where you actually feel on the ground with your toes. I love the Innovate trail shoes and fell shoes for that. You know, they've always been really flexible. You've always been able to feel what your feet are doing. It feels like the shoe's like an extension of your foot. You know, it feels like the grip's just like part of your foot. And they're trying to do that on the road shoe as well. Me personally, I think, you know, I'm going to stick to my mileage shoes. I'll stick to my nylon plated shoes for quicker running in sessions, and a carbon shoe for 5k, 10k. And this occasionally put on for a pair just for a change, just so you're varying things a little bit. I think if you do the same run on the same routes, the same pace over and over again, you're heading towards injuries. But changing your shoes, changing your shoe type, mixing things up, just keeps you on your toes, keeps you giving more variety. Also, not just the shoes, but the surface as well. I like to run on the roads, I like to run on serious trails, I like to run on all railway lines, I like to run on muddy paths, just mix things up. So my strides length, the strides shortening, and again, just a shoe like this, just fits in nice with all that. It's very rural where I live, so there's a lot of roads, but a lot of these roads lead to old railway lines. I think this shoe would be great for that sort of stuff as well. Also, it's a comfortable shoe to wear anyway. I think it's the sort of shoe that I would happily take on holiday with me. I could wear it with a pair of shorts, I could wear it with traveling, I could wear it to go for a road run if I'm away, if it's a dry climate and some trails. I think it's flexible enough to have that sort of ground feel on like dry trails as well. So I think it's just a really good all-rounder. It's a great shoe. It's about £100 now, and I think for that price, it fits into most people's rotations quite nice. But today I'm going to go for a little run on the roads where I live and just see how it feels. I've worn the shoe casually, so it is a little bit muddy on the bottom, but today is going to be my first run in the shoe. See, the sole pattern's quite nice there. It has got a little bit of an edge, but not for mud. I think certainly dry trails, we rely on stuff like that, would be really good. Anyway, I'll give it a quick go and see how I get on. So something else to mention is the shape of the shoe. Innovate have changed the shape. It's a more foot shaped shoe. So very very much like Ultras, the wider toe box, nice and snug around the midfoot. And it really feels like you know your foot's held nice, but your toes can just spread out. There's no pressure or nipping around the toe area, so it's just a really, really nice fitting shoe now. You can see it's nice and snug all around here. There's no excess material, and the toe box is just a nice shape. The fabric's nice and soft, not overly thick and overly padded. Again, the tongue, again, it's just enough. It's not like. Sometimes you've got tongues which are like massive sponges on your foot. That doesn't have that feel, it's more minimalistic. It's quite nice.
So today, because I'm doing a bit of a shoe review, I'm just doing a short run, but I'll be out for a little while because I'll be doing some videoing. So when I make my videos, I take my drone remote, which I just pop in here. The drone itself, just make sure everything's folded over. And then pop that in my vest as well. And then also, the other piece of equipment is my GoPro. So I'll just stick that in the back. Just tuck it away. There we go. And that's me set for my run for videoing. It is a little bit bulky and a bit awkward, but I want to make a video, so I have to take it with me. So I'll see you out there. So there you go, that was a short 3.5 mile loop around the doors where I live. As you can probably see, it's fantastic roads to run on. I mean, I'm a trail runner, so running around here feels fantastic. You know, I've got the fast surface of the tarmac, I've got the undulations of the trail, got all the beautiful views as well. It really feels like feels more like a trail run than a road run. So I think those shoes were superb for that. They had a trail shoe feel, like you could feel the responsiveness, you could feel the ground, but you had enough cushioning to protect your feet. Going out on the tight corners, it really felt like it was gripping into the ground, and you know, you can lean into the shoe, which felt good. Thanks to these super shoes, they're so highly stacked. When you go around corners quite tight, it kind of feels like you're going on a platform shoe. You feel like you're going to fall off the shoe. You didn't get that here, so those tight corners, I think it was really good for. I think a really good place for this shoe would be a park run shoe. I think somebody who runs 2 or 3 times a week and wants a shoe to do a park run in as well, you know, these tight circuits on mixtures of surfaces, I think this should be brilliant for that. For a more dedicated runner, someone who's doing running multiple times a week, I think it's a good shoe to slot in for those days where you want to wake your feet up and have more of a ground feel. So yeah, it was a really good run. I like the shoe. It's not a shoe I'd wear for every single run, but certainly it's a shoe I'd slot in my rotation.